Hello students, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we will talk about the relationship between average costs and average variable costs. For those who don't know what average costs are, there's a detailed video in my list. Please go and check that out first before coming back to this video. All right? When we talk about average costs and average variable costs, these two concepts are pretty crucial when it comes to understanding production efficiencies and profit maximization. So, without wasting any time further, let's take a look at what is the relationship between average cost and average variable cost. Just to have an overview, average cost would mean per unit total cost of production, and this is how we calculate average cost, which is total cost over quantity. When we talk about average cost, it is divided into two categories of cost. First is average fixed costs, and the second is average variable cost. Average fixed cost is basically the per unit fixed cost of production, whereas average variable cost is per unit variable cost of production. This is the way we calculate average fixed costs. Total cost has two components again. If you remember from our previous video, total cost comprises of total fixed costs and total variable cost. So average fixed cost is calculated as total fixed costs over total output, whereas average variable cost is calculated as total variable cost over total output. Let's take a look at the relationship between average cost and average variable cost. Now, this is how we will take a look at the relationship between AC and ABC curves. So this is a schedule. We have outputs measured in units going upwards from 0 to 5. The next is average cost. When we look at the trend, it falls and then it tends to rise. Average variable cost also has more or less the same trend. It is falling, reaching its minimum, becoming constant, and then it rises again. These two figures are plotted on the graph here, where we have this blue curve, which is average variable cost, which corresponds to this, and we have this purple curve, which is the average variable cost, and it corresponds to these figures. All right, so what we've simply done is we've just plotted these figures here. We've joined these dots to get at individual AC and ABC curves. Now, when we take a look at the relationship, so we see that throughout the figures that are given in the column for AC are greater than ABC. This is simply because AC has two components to it, as we studied in the previous slide, AFC, which is average fixed cost, and ABC, which is average variable cost. So it will always be greater than the variable cost components because of the existence of fixed cost components in it. The next thing that we need to see is the vertical distance between AC and ABC curves. The vertical distance, as I've mentioned here, between AC and ABC is a depiction of the average fixed costs. And we see that the distance between these two curves is decreasing with an increase in output here. This is simply because the gap between them is AFC, which is the average fixed cost, and average fixed cost will always continue to decline as the output tends to rise. However, at any given point of time, AC and ABC will never intersect each other because average fixed costs can never be zero. If we remember from our total cost video, we know that total fixed costs are always there even at zero level of output. Now, we need to also remember that both AC and ABC curves are U-shaped curves. I didn't mention that, but it has to be remembered that these are U-shaped curves simply because the law of variable proportions is applicable in both the scenarios. Now, another thing that we need to remember is the minimum point of AC curve, which is this point D, will always lie to the right side of the minimum point of ABC curve, which is point C. So the key important things to remember between this relationship between AC and ABC is AC, the figures of AC would always be greater than ABC by the amount of AFC, which is average fixed cost. The vertical distance between AC and ABC would be depicted by AFC, and it would always be declining. However, at any given point of time, AC and ABC would never intersect because average fixed costs are never zero. And both AC and ABC curves are U-shaped curves. All right, students, I'll meet you in another video with another topic. Bye now. Take care.